is elusive. And this can be proven by strolling down to the 33rd verse. In this same chapter, and it says, oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of Yahweh Hashem and Yahushua, how unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. So these judgments and ways of Yahweh Hashem and Yahushua translates to the doctrine, which again is unsearchable. Let's read this again. It says, oh, the depth of the riches, oh, the depth of the riches, both of the wisdom and knowledge of Yahweh Hashem and Yahushua, how unsearchable are his judgments and his ways past finding out. So again, you can't search out the Heavenly Father, which is accomplished by way of searching out the proper knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of the scriptures. No, it have to be revealed unto you, as it is written in the book of St. John, the 3rd chapter, around the 29th verse. A man can receive nothing, lest it come from above, from Yahweh Hashem Yahushua. So in essence, the Heavenly Father, through his Son, has to show himself. He has to reveal himself unto you. Which brings me right here to the book of Wisdom of Solomon, the 1st chapter. And starting at the 1st verse, it says, love righteousness, ye that be judges of the earth. Think of the Lord with a good heart, and in simplicity of heart, and in simplicity of heart, seek him. Yeah, what does the scripture mean when it say we should seek our Lord in simplicity of heart? Well, simply put, this translates to humbleness of mind, meaning you must be willing to yield to others. Pretty much, you ought to become as babes. This is what it means to seek the Lord